Hi everyone, welcome back to DMG chemistry classes and myself Dr. Mahendra Guleria. And in today's video I'm going to calculate work, heat, change in internal energy and change in enthalpy for an adiabatic reversible expansion of an ideal gas. And we know that during an adiabatic process no heat enters or leaves the system. Okay, so there will be no change in heat of the system. So we can write for an infinitesimal small change delta Q is equal to zero. And according to first law of thermodynamics, du is equal to delta Q plus delta W. And here process is adiabatic, so delta Q is equal to zero. So this equation number one can be written as du is equal to delta W. But this is the equation for very small changes. And for a finite change, equation number 2 will be written as delta U is equal to W. This means that change in internal energy is equal to work done. Okay. And if the work done is the work of expansion, as the gas expands against constant external pressure. So if we have the work which is the work of expansion, then W will be equal to minus PdV as discussed earlier. Okay, then du will be equal to minus PdV. Let it be equation number 4. And this equation has lot of significance. This equation tells us that the gas is doing work by spending its own internal energy. Because in this case, there is no supply of heat from outside because the process is adiabatic. Okay, so gas is doing work by spending its own internal energy. And when the gas will do work, then its temperature will fall. Because when gas is at higher internal energy initially, then it will be at higher temperature. And after doing work, it will be at low internal energy and at low temperature. Okay, so the temperature of the gas will fall after expansion. So here the final internal energy is less than the initial internal energy. So the change in internal energy will be negative. Okay, and we can also see from this equation that dV will be positive because the final volume will be less than the initial volume in this case. Understanding? So dV will be positive and positive multiplied by negative will be negative. So this equation also tells us that the change in internal energy will be negative. Okay. Further, we know that CV is equal to dU upon dt. We have derived this expression in our previous videos. So CV is equal to dU upon dt, and from this equation we have dU is equal to CV dt. Understanding? So the total change in internal energy, that is delta U, can be calculated from this equation number 6 by integrating this equation between limits U1 to U2 and temperatures from T1 to T2. Okay, and we know that differential and integral cancel each other. Then we have U and initial internal energy is U1 and finally U2. And let us suppose that this heat capacity at constant volume remains constant over this temperature range, that is T1 to T2. So it will be outside the sign of integration, and we have dt inside, and again differential and integral cancel each other, and we will be having t here. Then we know that upper limit minus lower limit U2 minus U1 will be equal to CV and T, it is initial temperature T1 and final T2. So delta U will be equal to CV into T2 minus T1. And here delta U will be equal to CV delta T. So this is the required expression for the change in internal energy. And from equation number 3, the change in internal energy is also equal to the work done. So the work done is going to have the same expression. So W will be equal to Cv into T2 minus T1 or Cv into delta T. So these were the relationships for your change in internal energy and for the work done. Okay. So now let us derive expression for the change in enthalpy. And we know that enthalpy H is equal to U plus PV. So enthalpy H is equal to U plus PV, and let it be the equation number 9. Okay, and from this equation delta H will be equal to delta into U plus PV. Okay, and delta H is equal to delta U plus delta PV. Then delta H is equal to delta U plus delta RT, because PV is equal to RT for the 1 mole of an ideal gas. Further, delta H is equal to delta U, R is a gas constant, then we have R into delta T. Now let us substitute the value of delta U from equation number 7 in this equation. Okay, then delta H will be equal to Cv delta T plus R into delta T. Okay, and delta H is equal to Cv plus R into delta T. Delta T is common, and we know that Cv minus Cv is equal to R, then Cp is equal to Cv plus R, and let it be equation number 10. So we will substitute Cv plus R equal to Cp in equation number 10. Then this delta H will be equal to delta H will be equal to Cp into delta T, that equation 11. So this is the required expression for the enthalpy change. And we can see that both expressions, that is expression for delta U and expression for delta H, in both these expression, this value of delta H and delta U depends upon what? Delta T, that is change in temperature. This means that we are going to have different delta H and delta U for the reversible and irreversible processes. Because in case of reversible and irreversible processes, we are going to have different delta T, because T1 and T2 will be different. Because both the processes, they have different mechanisms. Reversible process takes place very, very slowly, whereas there is no such restriction for the irreversible process. Okay, so we will be having different delta H, different delta U, and different work done during reversible and irreversible expansion of an ideal gas adiabatically. Okay, so these were the different expressions for work, for heat. Heat is obviously Q is equal to 0 in this case, internal energy and delta H. So I hope that you have enjoyed today's video, and if you have enjoyed it, then please do like and share my videos, and also subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.